so I'm going to take the bag off to the side here and just start bringing items out to the fleece-covered table. So the first addition I have is the canteen pouch. There's a liter of water in an Algene canteen. Otherwise, inside the canteen pouch lives a Pathfinder cup stove kit. Fits in there nicely, so it's got the handle that kicks around. Pardon me. So I've got the stove kit first, and then the canteen, which has the slider to hold it down, and also has the graduations inside, if you can see that there. And the way they work is together. If you've never seen one before, this is the stove that goes on the ground. This is your feed chute where you can put a small fire or a fire tablets or such. Then the kidney shaped are matched. So one goes on top of the other. When the flame is there, go ahead, you boil your water. The other thing I've got in here, and this is why this weighs so much, is a lot of this is metal in here, is of course the heavy cover lid, which has strainers on both sides, or steam letter outers, and that goes right on top of this cup here. Okay, so that's a bit of weight right there. And what else have we got in the canteen pouch? On this side we have a hot chocolate from one of my MREs, and even though I don't usually eat them or drink them, got a instant coffee on that side. On this side we have a box of matches and a couple of fire starter cubes, a couple of that brand, two of those, and then there's one of this brand. Okay. That's the contents of the canteen pouch. We'll spin you around and get you onto the other side now. Alright, so now we're going to look in the pouch behind the canteen pouch. To keep in mind, this is chock-a-block. Alright, happy Halloween. Some candies here. We have a spray-on hand sanitizer. We have a package of wet wipes. We have an all-weather poncho, courtesy of somebody who sells Rothko. We have some paracord. I think this is a 50-foot of woodland. There you go. Let's see the pattern on that. We have a little scope. Let's see something from a distance. I don't want to carry binoculars, so I carry a monocular. This one is a 15 to 20 to 55 power, 15 to 55 by 21 degrees monocular. It's a real pain in the butt when it's at high magnification if you're holding on to it, but it does have a hole here where you can mount it on a tripod, just a regular camera screw. So that's really handy if you have one of these guys. And that is it for that pouch. All right, we'll spin you around to the next. And actually, I just about missed it, but there is a one of the Condor neck wraps in here, which you can make into like the ninja mask or neck warmer, etc. That's actually finally it. All right, we're now at the other end of the bag. See, I've got a Grimlock on here. That's for keychains, etc. If I want to hook something on the outside. Oh, another candy bar. I have four titanium tent pegs, or stakes, for whatever you're going to use it for. I have a bottle of the tabs, of the hydration tabs, so you put that in your water and it is an electrolyte charged. I have a bag closer. If you have a bag of chips and you want to close it up, do it right. I have a piece of fatwood. I went through my stash and picked one that's very resinous and very deep in color, so I'm hoping it's really good to go if I ever need it for a fire. I have a titanium spork. And, believe it or not, I have a 5x7 tarp in here. This is one of the ones from Malcolm at the Hidden Woodsman. It's Silnai. I believe it's OD green, but it's extremely thin, extremely lightweight, with lots of heavy-duty tie-outs. Okay. I'm going to be doing a series on tarps next spring, because now I've got quite the complement of them. I can set them up in a large area all together and do some real good review of that. So, there you go. Contents of that pouch. So I just got to mention that I carry this around by this top handle. You can't get into these pouches without opening these clips up and flipping that handle over. So that, it's a bit tedious, but I don't know that really there's a better way to design that, because it's good and sturdy with its two straps across. The other option, of course, is to use the shoulder strap, which is removable. You can pull that off right here. You don't need to use that. It's got a nice sliding pad on it, padded one side, not the other, so it moves around quite well, depending on where your shoulder mounts into the system. I'm just going to tuck that off to the side for now. So we'll unclick here. Got some stretchy webbing here. You could put something in there that's fairly bulky if you wanted to, but imagine you either have to get this under it or this over it. So it's just a logistical issue. Top pouch. There we have some leftover jerky, a couple granduars, granola bar, a cup of soup, and up here, Clif Bar, spiced pumpkin pie. Haven't tried it yet. So there is room for some stuff up on the top. That pouch is expandable. It does have some room to billow. Move down to the pouch beside it, which is this one here. So there's some molly webbing on here with a bit of Velcro. You could put a name tape on there or an honor badge or a morale patch if you wanted. One of the improvements, I've just got to mention it, from the first edition is these zipper pulls now have a piece of paracord on them instead of a metal thing that clanks all over the place. So this is a really quiet pack now. Definitely a bonus to have that system. Okay, side pouch. We have an EDC kit. You've seen this before. This is a 600-pound rated beaner. Got Smith sharpener on there, carbide, ceramic, and a little diamond rod. Pace beads, whistle, a thermometer compass. Here's north. There's Light My Fire, I believe, product. It could be a different brand. Yeah, I think it just Light My Fire, but this is one of those sparky tools where you scrape this rod on there and you jam it into the ground. Normally packs like that. Opens up here with a squeeze. Okay. And a light. And a can opener, P51. That covers a lot of bases right there. I also have a UltraPod camera tripod. I have chapstick, another candy bar, a Fola cup. I've got a few of these now. I find them really handy. And I've got an inhaler for if I have an asthma issue. And normally, the other pouch here is the remote for my camera that you're now watching me through, and the camera that is taping me here. That normally sits in these little pouches right on the side. So that's the side pouches, and I'll bring you back here. I have to mention there is also a little latch in here you could hang your keys off of or something that has a lanyard and put it back in the pouch to keep track of it. All right, now we're going to look in the large compartment, the main compartment as it were. Okay, so there is a zippered top area here where you could put more things. This is elasticated, so if you needed to tuck something under there, it would be doable. First thing we come to is my personal first aid kit with an extra pair of gloves and a one-way valve mask in here, foldy. This, you can see the contents of this in one of my previous videos. Just go down to the bottom to the search and search for first aid. This is one of the medium pack towels, very lightweight, really handy, very absorbent. One more protein bar. Salt and pepper. There you go. And another bag if you needed to carry water. This is another zipper top style. This is a paleo stove. Now, I got sent one of these to do the video for it, and I haven't had any outside time since. I'm starting to feel kind of bad about it because I've had it more than a month. But this one, keep an eye on my channel, and you will see a video with the paleo stove, which is just super thin, super lightweight. It's a three-piece folding fire stove to run off of biologicals like wood or dung or whatever else, pine cones, etc. Their idea, they said, was to use a fire stove that combined the small folding fire stoves with the pot stand and keep it really simple. So, like I said, keep an eye out for that, please. It'll be out soon, hopefully. I have my water filter kit. This one contains a Sawyer Mini and the accoutrements that go with it, as well as some backup tablets, just in case. About 20 liters worth of tablets in there. And this is a pouch from my buddy Malcolm at the Hidden Woodsman. He makes these. Then they're really inexpensive and it fits this kit perfectly. We have a Grand Trunk Ultralight hammock. This is the one you see if you follow me on Instagram or otherwise Twitter and such. This is the OD green one that I use. A couple of S loops at the end of it. S hooks, pardon me. So there's my shelter. Here's the straps that I use currently to hang that. That is very high strength rated, but very easy to tie and untie. So there's two straps there of 3 meters length each. And I have a drum liner that I've had for a while, so it's got some beat up marks in it. It may not hold water, but it would be reasonably good. Between this and that 5x7 tarp, I'm sure I can make some sort of shelter that's reasonable. Now I have these, and I haven't tried them yet. And they're sport beans from Jelly Belly. Feels like they might be degrading in that bag, so I should probably end soon. What else do we have? We have another compartment here. The Velcro tab over. There's my Becker Kabar Hybrid. I think it's a BK-14. Nice little knife. Yes, BK-14. And I use this reasonably often. I mean, it's got some marks on there. It's seen some stuff. It's seen a fire rod or something there. Clicks back in with a positive click, and there's a little bit more paracord as well for the need should arise. Okay, I'm going to put this back together, and we'll go and have a look at the side pouch over here. And then we're going to the last pouch here. This is attached with the Molly Pals webbing. There is a Velcro mesh front pouch here, which I don't use currently. There's some more Velcro if you want to put your morale badge or your name tape on. The zippers are nice, but they've got these little dangly tabs on them that kind of bonk around a bit. Just before I finish, this is the OneTigris pack. This is not OneTigris. This is surplus, not OneTigris. So those are just add-ons that I put on there, so I'm not judging the OneTigris brand on this. I don't remember what brand this was. I think I may have got this from England as a sergeant's pouch or something along those lines. Okay, I have a pair of gloves. Thru-Knight TIS, I think. Yeah, TIS, so it's just the one brightness. I've got a astronaut pen, right in the rain, small pen. Got Uncle Bill's silver sliver grippers, pair of tweezers. And if you've seen the review on this pouch, you can go right through the end if you wish. And a spare AAA, because I have done a review on the contents of this pouch not too long ago. There's a tin there with your Altoids kit, the usual things inside, a right in the rain pad, a lighter. So that's that. I will take these three Ranger bands off of here quickly. You can see there's a hole on the top if you want to char something. This one has not been used for charring. It's not totally discolored and black. And in here we have Camelback cleaning tabs. We have some more fresh water, water purifying tablets. Another blade in here. This is the CRKT Doug Ritter, a little tiny knife, skeletonized blade, Kydex sheath, sharp as all get out, doesn't weigh much, and it's also got a nice lanyard here. There's a couple of Reactin type things for allergies. There's another fire rod and scraper. This one is also Light My Fire. See, it has been used a couple times. And then the rest in here is tinder, some jute twine and some dryer lint. And then the last couple items, which I've also shown on one of my other videos, I got this from thecanteenshop.com. This is the accessories kit for one of the Swiss Army knives, and they were selling these for $1 for the pack of two. So I think I bought 4 packages or 5 packages, so now I have tweezers and that toothpick type item in multiple locations. So that's it for that little kit. We'll go back over here. We have one of those towel pills. You put that in water and it expands into a paper towel for a couple of uses at least. There's a few first aid items in here, a couple band-aids, benzalkonium wipes to clean up. And that is mesh backed and plastic on the front. We have a larger zipper top type bag. Depending on what you're using to cook with, the fish mouth hanger, you can use that to hang a bottle, but currently this package does not have that type of bottle used in it. That's it for that side. Then I have another knife. I have the KSSK. Nice simple blade. And last few items in here. No, the last item in here is a pair of tip grabbers. You can see that there. Got a hooked little blade, and you kind of get in underneath them, squeeze them, and roll them out. Bring that up close. All right, so that's the contents of and the brief discussion on this pack. The last thing to touch on is that it also has a waist strap potential. So you can pull this out. You've got a padded waist belt. Now, mine's a little bloated for a pack, so I wouldn't carry this as a waist belt because it's too heavy at 10 pounds. But if you use the original pack and had this kept simple, if you had a hammock and straps in here, and then perhaps a small pocket rocket stove and a bottle of fuel, a very lightweight pot, and a spork and some food to heat up, that wouldn't be too bad. You could probably do that on the waist straps. For me, this doesn't really work for my system, so I just keep that tucked away and under there. I haven't taken to considering de-stitching them and removing them from the pack, because you never know. In the future, you might want to use it because it's got that molly on there, the PALS webbing, that it might become part of the system. The other option is you can attach it here with its own molly PALS to a larger pack of something else. The bottom has these straps, which are attached to the handle, drain holes throughout, and every pouch has a drain hole. This front one does not have a drain hole. I believe this is considered water repellent quite highly, but not water proof. Thank you for joining me on that video, and we'll see you on the next one.